The Mike Douglas Show, weekdays at 3:30 on Channel 4.
Tonight on the CBS Tuesday Night Movies. A demon driver takes over the road and dares the cops to catch him. Joe Don Baker and Tyne Daly join the chase for the mysterious Roadrunner. A supercharged drama of high-powered excitement and lightning-fast action.
I've been playing daughter roles for so long that people forget I'm grown up with kids of my own. I'm certainly grown up enough to know that soap can dry out your face, so I wash with Noxzema skin cream every day. Noxzema makes my face feel really clean. It doesn't dry, it puts moisture in, makes my skin feel soft, younger looking. I've been washing with Noxzema for a long time now, and well, so far so good.
Good skin starts with Noxzema every day. Greaseless, medicated Noxzema skin cream.
Mrs. Cooper, I must be blind. I don't see my dog changing the way you say.
Now look, people change, dogs change. Their nutritional needs change. So I say to help keep him healthy, his dog food ought to meet those changing needs.
Can one dog food do all that?
The four cycle dog foods can. And cycle one feeds puppies the way you feed babies, with the extras to grow on.
And for adult dogs in their active years.
Like mine.
Mm-hmm. There's cycle two to help keep him healthy and alert. Come on, Sam.
And as one gets older, one's system becomes more delicate, so cycle four is made for the special digestion of dogs over seven.
Why, there's even cycle three for less active dogs who should have fewer calories. Like some people I know.
Mrs. Cooper, you've sure opened my eyes to how dogs change.
So I say, change him to Cycle and take real good care of him, huh? Cycle, nutrition for the life of your dog.
It's Showtime at your Litton microwave oven dealer, featuring the fabulous $50 rebate on our best models.
I always wanted a Litton. He always wants to save.
I'll show you how Litton's exclusive even wave system cooks food to juicy perfection.
The food is delicious.
The Litton's terrific.
And I'll show you how to get a $50 rebate from Litton. So come on in, see the show.
And save some dough.
Litton Showtime and fabulous $50 rebate. Playing now through September 30th at participating dealers near you.
Thank you.
Control, come in. Come in, Control. This is 1EZ8 repeating.
Roger, 1EZ8. This is Control. Over.
I'm in pursuit of a red Jansen interceptor bearing a Born license plate number
on the CB. See if you can raise your buddy.
Okay.
Oh, here it comes.
Captain, listen. No, there's nothing new. There are no new developments.
Please give us the latest.
Look, there's got to be something else going on in this town besides the road running.
This is what's going on.
I'll give you a call just as soon as anything breaks for us, okay? Drives me nuts.
Captain? Captain, we couldn't reach you. Stoney almost bought the farm yesterday. He's in the hospital. Looks like he's going to be there for quite a while.
Yeah, I can read the report, Fleming. Why don't you give me something new for a change, okay?
Well, Annie took the call as he was pursuing this Jensen interceptor. She said that just before he reported the plate numbers, a weird whine blocked out the transmission.
Weird whine? That's new.
Negative, Captain. It's happened once before, but it wasn't in the report.
Why the hell wasn't it?
Yeah.
Captain, the chief is on his way, 2 feet off the ground.
Okay. Captain Hogan.
I know. The city council is very nervous. And the mayor is very upset and wants you to shake out the department. Almost out the door again, right?
Frank, these car thefts are getting to be a bigger problem. The mayor and the city council want fast answers.
What can I tell you? This two-bit creep, this road runner, the press jocks like to call him, He doesn't leave any clues. Until this morning.
Now you're making me smile.
He's got to be some kind of an electronics whiz. He's interrupted a couple of our pursuit calls with some kind of a high-frequency electronic gadget or something. That's one reason why we haven't been able to get any backup on our chase cars.
How badly were you hurting?
Four patrol cars totaled. Two men in the hospital. State troopers have lost two cars, one guy hurt. And this morning, they tossed the whole thing in our laps. They say it's our baby. Kevin, I've got every available officer on it, night and day. I don't know what else I can do.
Well, I've got a surprise for you. You're going to get some additional help.
Yeah, how's that?
The five or six insurance companies involved have decided to pool their efforts and money, and they've hired their own private investigator to work with us.
Look, I don't need any prima donna Seamus on the case, okay?
You better reconsider, and fast. His name is Novick.
No, sir. Not while I'm on this case, no way.
Not Novick.
New police commissioner. Am I close?
Official police business.
What the hell is this?
Oh, sorry, officer. Wrong card.
Without question, but it's credible.
Wait a minute.
Look, this is not necessary.
I'm here to see your Captain Hogan. He told me to get here as fast as I possibly could.
Well, you're here, funny man. We'll see the good captain in his office.
No, not like this.
Like this.
He says he's a friend of yours, Captain.
Get these things off me, friend. And what's all this jazz about 72 tickets?
73. You just got another one. Take them off.
Look, I just came here for a little cooperation. Besides, you owe me one.
I owe you nothing.
Well, how quick they forget. The Gonzalez case. You remember that one?
Pretty dear. What do you want?
Well, like I said, just a little cooperation and communication.
A little cooperation and communication.
Yes, sir.
Okay, Mr. Novick, here's your cooperation.
Thank you.
These black flags here spot where this character stole the 10 cars. Make that 11 cars. The red flags are where we lost them.
Got any clues, witnesses?
No, there's no pattern. 5 day snatches, 6 at night. Had a couple of witnesses this morning. Neither one of them could give us a description. And he somehow can blank out our frequencies with some kind of sophisticated electronic gadget. Obviously, he's a hell of a driver. Probably pro experience.
Any of these cars ever show up?
Not a hubcap. Huh. You got a list of these vehicles?
Yeah, right here. Jaguars, Citroens, BMWs, Mercedes, Ferraris.
But his total was set up to a couple hundred thousand.
Yeah, why don't you tell me about it? Now, Mr. Novick, for your communications, I'm gonna give you the best officer on the force.
Well, hot damn.
Come along, I'll give you a personal introduction.
Officer Nolan, this is Pete Novick, private eye with some kind of a reputation which escapes me right now.
My God, it's a nifty nun on North Beach.
Hello, quick hands.
Well, you obviously know one another. Where the hell did this happen?
Oh, one of them karate chop sake classes up there in San Francisco.
Oh.
She's also a notorious disco dancer on the side.
I don't recall that on your application.
No.
Novick represents these insurance companies on this roadrunner thing. Get your head together with him, see what you can come up with, okay?
The hard part is developing a profile on this roadrunner character. Sure. We don't know enough about how he does what he does to match up with the sinister characters in the computer. But we did get something good today.
Let me guess. I bet he's an electronical wizard and he's got a gadget that just overpowers the radio frequency. Yeah?
Well, you are up to date.
Sure, Miss Watt.
And in that case, I'm going to call this short. No, I've got a meeting.
Wait a minute, how's
the
lunch with
me? No, I have a class
me?
To teach, City College, police communications methods. I'm very good at it, and I've got time
okay,
to get it out.
I found you again.
And change my clothes.
Oh, leave me again.
Come on, walk me out.
Glad to.
I miss San Francisco. We did have good times, didn't we?
Yeah.
But I never did get my black belt.
Oh, good. Say, can we meet later tonight? Nifty. We have a drink later tonight?
Okay.
Okay. 7 o'clock, Turquoise Lounge.
Okay.
Okay.
There's something special about you, baby. It's your psychic illuminations that I feel.
Ketchup, tomatoes, onions.
Mustard, ketchup, and mayonnaise.
Cheese, lettuce, and onions.
Onions, mustard, and pickles.
Tomatoes, relish, and cheese.
At Wendy's, you get lots and lots of your favorite toppings. Anyone who offers less is giving you less of a hamburger.
Double your pleasure with Double Mint Gum. Double good, double fresh, double delicious. It's the single most favorite double in the world.
Jumping double, double jumping, on the double, seeing double. But the single most favorite double in the world is double good, double good, double mint gum.
There's no single gum like it.
Here, Luke.
Thanks, Mr. Escondon.
Did your dad make these?
You mean at his restaurant?
Yeah, how did you get so thin and crispy?
You didn't. You didn't?
No, Luke. They're Tostitos brand tortilla chips.
But they make them like I would, with stone ground corn, in traditional flavor, and nacho cheese.
He didn't make them, but he could if he wanted to.
Tostitos, an authentic tortilla taste from Frito-Lay.
We now return to Speedtrap, starring Joe Don Baker.
Gumshoe to Forefather at the base, come in. Gumshoe to Forefather at the base, come in.
Oh, come on in, Renegade.
Never mind that, partner. Did you get an advance on your new job? We need some bread, you know.
No, not yet. Say, what do you know about this character they call the Roadrunner?
Nothing really, but he must be some classy driver. You know that some of those cars have got our modifications in them, don't you?
Yeah, that's what I suspected. Say, in the meantime, start checking out any drivers that have any special knowledge of electronics. You know, TV, radio, whatever.
Will do, Gumshoe. Say, if you need some extra help, why don't you give Harry's sister a try?
Try Harry's sister?
Yeah, she's sort of a magician, you know, a psychic or whatever they call them. Maybe she can see something that you don't, and she is awful good looking.
Yeah, whatever. Say, right now, I'm going out to check out the auto wreckers. Well, there's a chance you might get a call from a gal named Nifty Nolan. If you do, take the message and call me for sure.
Roger, Gumshoe.
All right, over and out.
Out.
Baker 2.
I'm heading north on Washington in pursuit of the 1971 Red Mustang. We'll need possible cutoff assistance.
Now this is 9 Charlie 1. I heard your transmission. I'm headed east on College Street, headed toward Curry Avenue, and we'll assist.
Repeat your location, please.
I'm headed east on College Street.
I'm not exactly sure where that is. Now I got it.
You're right here. What are you doing?
You're doing fine, Miss Hastings, just fine.
Oh, thank you. Tell me, Mr. Hancock, you a married man?
Leroy, call me Leroy.
Okay. Leroy, are you married man?
No, I'm separated.
Oh, well,
Have you ever taken lessons from a qualified instructor before?
Oh, sure, about a year ago.
No,
there was
keep,
a guy...
keep your eyes on the road.
Yeah. Yes,
please
sure.
Keep your eyes on the road.
Sure.
Now, whenever you hear a siren, you should hand signal and just pull over to the side of the road. You understand that?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Okay.
I think that'll be enough for today, Miss Hastings.
Oh, boy, I saw the whole thing. It wasn't your fault.
Thank you.
lady.
My car, you were sitting right here. You must have seen
me. Oh, Lee, I've been sitting on this bench off and on for a year. I've seen an awful lot of strange things, but I ain't never seen no car turn itself on.
Oh, that's impossible. You're drunk.
That's a real truism, madam. But I'm telling you, I seen the door locks pop up by themselves and the engine go on by itself. But there weren't no one in that car. Believe me.
That's nonsense. You got a good look at who it was, and you're going to describe him to the police.
I don't think so, lady. All I saw was something black. Maybe a little black box. Unless you got shades in that limousine of yours. Little drinky?
And in pursuit of Green Charger heading west on Washington Boulevard.
Arizona license ULE042.
Hastings, just drive up to the street and turn right.
Just drive. Okay. Oh! Gee, I'm sorry, Mr. Barth. But you know, they really shouldn't put those curves so close together.
Keep to your right.
License now, Mr. Barth.
Not today, Miss Hastings. Not today.
Charger. It's a green one. Why don't you check the plate numbers?
Oh, yeah.
Officer, my name is Pete Novick. I'm on the same case you are. Didn't Captain Hogan tell you guys?
I've been chasing that Charger for 10 minutes, and somebody's getting busted. Yet. You!
Come on.
Isn't this a lovely automobile? Clean as a whistle. Now, this beauty. By a little old preacher. The only time he used his car was to take parishioners to church every Sunday morning.
Yes, sir, folks. I was every... Hey. Hey! Hey! Hey, where are you going with my car? Come back! Hey!
Control, this is 6 David 1.
I have a streaking green Cadillac heading north on 12th Street. Am unable to read license numbers. May need backup. Repeat, may need backup.
Roger, 681. We'll comply. Code 2.
Repeat your location.
I said I just joined Butts on the Canal. And now I'm 4 feet in it.
It's number 12. That's not even my birthday.
Arthritis hurts. Even getting dressed can be a painful experience.
But one prescription drug, which gives some people relief from this pain, comes from a chemical that's made by my employer, the Phillips Petroleum Company. I like that. It's good to know your company's work helps people. I take the drug myself. It's what helps me get to work some days.
Phillips Petroleum. Good things for cars and the people who drive them.
Hey, the Fruit of the Loom guys.
Catfish Hunter!
Hey, the Star Picture buys our underwear.
Before I made the big leagues, I bought them for the price.
What a price!
Now I buy what's quality.
Like our Super Bend waistband.
Snaps back, wash after wash. That's quality.
Hey, Catfish, could you get us tickets?
Guys, I take you to every game.
Men's cotton briefs, only $1.33 each. Our price will get you. Our quality will keep you.
What do doctors recommend for pain today? This report shows doctors' number one choice is the pain reliever in Anacin. 5 million recommendations last year for pain of headache, backache, minor arthritis, and muscle ache. The ingredient in Anacin is the doctor's number one choice. Anacin is strong, a special combination of medical ingredients free of stomach upset for millions everywhere. The ingredient in Anacin, doctor's number one choice.
Tell me what my lips say to you.
Soft. Soft.
Wet.
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 What?
Whipped. Moisture Whip. My lipstick. Whipped with moisturizers to help keep my lips very soft. So whipped up, I call them my whipsticks. And I love them.
And I love your lips.
Moisture Whip Whipstick with protective sunscreen. Lipstick by another name is not Whipstick by Maybelline.
We will return to Joe Don Baker in Speed Trap.
We're looking good.
Hey, these kids have the fever, California fever, when every day is sun and fun and every night is something else. Fun-loving, freewheeling guys and gals share the excitement under the California sun. Jimmy McNichol, Mark McClure, Lorenzo Lamas, and Michelle Tobin star in California Fever. Catch it this fall and have a ball Tuesday nights.
Looking good.
This is CBS.
Lots of things can break a windshield, but there's just one thing to remember when you need replacement glass. The Service Auto Glass full warranty. As long as you own your car, we'll fix free any defect in material or workmanship. We've put it in writing, and that's reliability worth looking into. Service Auto Glass. See us in the Yellow Pages.
Get service, service, service. Service Auto Glass, and get the job done fast.
Red Lobster asks, what did you have for lunch today?
No, that was...
A burger and fries, you know, the usual.
Here's something you'd remember. Lunch at Red Lobster. How about flounder or shrimp scampi? That's Red Lobster, you seafood lover, you. Lunches that are easily affordable and, oh, unforgettable.
Red Lobster for the seafood lover in you.
Now, what are you doing for lunch tomorrow?
Clarice Tinsley, tonight at 10, only on Channel 4.
We now return to Speed Trap, starring Joe Don Baker.
Notorious Texas Nun strikes again.
Murray, triple this time, please.
Coming right up, Pete.
Boy, little Miss No-Show Nolan.
Hey.
What?
I'm sorry. Hey. I'm late. I'm sorry.
Hey, have a seat. You still drink Stingers?
Yes.
Murray, Stinger for the lady.
Stinger for the lady. Coming up.
Thank you.
Oh, I've been chasing around all day. How about you? What's new besides getting arrested twice?
Oh, you heard about that, huh? Well, I bet you didn't hear about the Roadrunner and the Rolls Royce.
No.
Good. Well, this old bum wino, he says that... Thank you, Murray. That, the Roadrunner, he's got this gadget. It's in a black box. And he can open doors with it, and he can start engines.
That's impossible.
Cool. And he is nowhere around when he does it.
Well, that could keep you up all night.
Hey, you want some dinner?
It's what I got dressed up for.
Murray, I'm going to need your frequency, home phone number, and home address. It's business. Murray, let me have your pen for the lady.
Sure.
Thanks. Oh, and Murray, we're going to have dinner. Can we have that booth over there?
That's fine.
Okay, and put these on a tab. Can you bring them?
I'll bring them right over.
Thank you.
Don't you knock on my door after midnight.
You never change.
You should see me after midnight.
Thank you.
Are you Mr. Novick, Billy's partner?
Yeah.
Hi. I'm New Blossom, Harry's sister. Billy said you could use my help.
Oh, you do the psychic thing.
Yes, but only when I'm completely relaxed. Then it just sort of comes to me.
Well, just come on in. I'm sorry, I'm a little confused. It's been a bad day, and I was just about ready to go to bed.
Say that again.
Just about ready to go to bed.
That sounds very relaxing. Oh, you're so cute, I can't stand it. I'm gonna go make coffee.
You make omelets?
Don't get pushy.
Oh, sorry. Hey.
Yeah?
What were you saying last night? Before I dropped off to sleep, something about the Roadrunner?
Oh, I said the only picture I got was that of an ornament or a medallion. It wasn't very clear, and the Roadrunner doesn't always wear it. I can't really explain it. That's all that came to me.
Our police are investigating the attempt of a car theft in the Country Club neighborhood area. The man, who was scared off by a watchdog, escaped. While police have not released any official information, KWIK News has learned from an informed source that the man is thought to be the notorious car thief, the Roadrunner.
Hey, wait a minute! Hey, turn the news off.
Well, I like music in the morning. Not into all that violence. I like KWIK
News. Well, violence is my meal ticket.
Mm.
Look, I'm gonna have to run. You let yourself out. Okay.
Sure.
Captain Hogan. Larry Loomis. Good morning, Captain. Just fine. Mr. S has some real good news for you. Come on.
Yes, Francis, I do have some good news for you.
That Christmas package arrived by plane last night, about sundown. The gifts have been distributed already.
That's good to hear.
And by the way, Francis, have you decided what you want to do with that big warehouse that we...
that you bought last month?
No, I haven't, but, you know, I'm working on it.
Francis, I'm giving a little cocktail party tonight, so why don't you stop by? You come in the back way, of course. Larry wants to shake your hand in a big way.
You understand what I mean?
Yeah, I can't make it tonight. I'm up to my eyeballs in these car thefts. Everybody's screaming. I'm sure the mayor will be next.
All right. Goodbye, Francis.
I just call your place. Yeah? Harry's sister told me she came through good for you. She is good, man. I tell you, really good, huh?
Well, she came through with a possible clue, but I don't believe her.
Well.
What'd you call me for?
Hey, maybe nothing, but a few minutes ago the phone rang and this weird-sounding guy got on and told me that he was a Roadrunner, that he wants to talk to you. Can you believe all that? I mean, every creep wants to get into the act.
What do you sound like?
Nifty calling Gumshoe. You ready, Gumshoe?
10-4, Nifty's Gumshoe, over.
Good morning. I just wanted to report you still have a chance for the brass ring. Over.
Are you talking about that incident with a man and dog last night? Over.
Roger, the person had a black case, but it was filled with the usual tools of the trade. He was a pro, but not the Roadrunner.
Huh. My, my, the bonus looks bigger every minute. Over. Hmm. Nifty, respond. Over.
I'll read you, Gumshoe. I just got a report that 6 Bravo 2 is in hot pursuit of a white caddy Eldorado heading south on McKinley Boulevard. Go get him, quick hands. I'm off to TV-12. Over now.
Fun and games. See you later.
heard a lot of fun, boy?
Hey, man, you could kill somebody. Look what you did to my car.
Car? What car?
Wait till my dad hears about this. He's a lawyer. He's gonna make you look like a jerk.
Look, Mercury Heels, you're in big trouble. Now let's have the license.
I must have left it at home. Cuff him. Hey, I'm not causing any trouble. I'm nonviolent.
Well, if that's the Roadrunner, then I'm a 4-foot sword swallow with a 6-foot sword.
Catch a breeze and feel the sail, following the sun. Hear the summer calling you, good times have begun. And it's the time for 7-Up, so crisp and clean and light. That refreshing taste, so crystal clear, and summer is just right. Move it up,
line up,
reach it up,
dive it up.
America is turning 7-Up. Look it up,
splash it up,
feel it up,
beat it up.
America is turning 7-Up.
Wet nail color. Nothing looks as slick. Nothing looks as shiny.
Now you can have that look, even when it's dry.
It's easy with CoverGirl Nail Slicks, the amazing nail color that slicks on rich with a shine that never lets go.
Nail slicks strengthen too, so nails feel strong, last long. My nails look wet, even when they're dry.
CoverGirl Nail Slicks.
Nobody would ever clean a sink with sandpaper, right? Yet most powdered cleansers contain the same abrasive as this sandpaper. And in time, they can scratch your kitchen and bathroom surfaces. But now there's Soft Scrub, the liquid with mild abrasives. Soft Scrub doesn't scratch like powdered cleansers, yet it cleans even the worst messes like this kitchen grease. See? So for cleanser clean without all that cleanser scratch, use Soft Scrub.
My flashlight's almost always on, so I use Duracell batteries.
Mine sits for months, but when I need it, it works, because I use Duracell. Duracell batteries last longer.
We tested 2-year-old Duracell batteries against brand new regular carbon batteries, and in continuous use, 2-year-old Duracell batteries still lasted up to 5 times longer. Duracell. The copper top battery.
Every night on the job,
or after sitting for months, Duracell lasts longer.
We will return to Joe Don Baker in Speed Trap.
Wednesday night, America's most popular actor, John Wayne, stars in a 3-hour television event, The High and the Mighty. On a perilous flight, 21 people and 21 stories are united by fate.
We'll all be killed.
With a pilot about to crack.
Those controls back where they belong.
And an old warhorse co-pilot fighting to hold it together.
No, we don't. Get a hold of yourself.
The High and the Mighty. Wednesday at 8, 7, Central and Mountain.
Tomorrow on CBS.
A lot of ice creams can tell you they're all natural, even though they put in stabilizers or thickeners like gums and gelatin. At Breyers, we pledge that our ice cream contains none of those things. Breyers uses nothing but ripe fruit, pure sugar, wholesome milk, and thick cream. There just isn't any other ice cream that's more all-natural than Breyers.
What's with the question mark on the Viva package?
Viva. Isn't it paper towel or isn't it?
Oh, of course it's paper. It's Viva.
Viva.
Harry? Mm-hmm. Does that feel like paper to you?
Wow. I could use these to polish my car.
But it's called Viva.
It comes on a roll, so it's gotta be paper.
Mother says it's not a paper towel.
Viva, is it a paper towel or isn't it?
Now on stage at the Dallas Theater Center, the new Preston Jones comedy, Remember. Call the box office for reservations. Barry Judge, tonight at 10, only on Channel 4.
We now return to Speed Trap, starring Joe Don Baker.
Mm-hmm.
flight 14 to New York City, now arriving at 8:25.
Milano. What? What do you mean it's gone? Are you nuts? Hold on a second. You look in that damn lot. You look at every damn car. And you come back in that car. I don't care what that Puerto Rican pile driver said. He's probably got two glass eyes. You call me back in 5 minutes with good news. Yeah, give me Captain Hogan.
Call for you, Captain. Line one.
Thanks, Fleming. Captain Hogan.
Hogan, we got big trouble. Some creeps have stole one of my cars.
Well, welcome to the club, Al. I'll put you on the preferred customers list.
Listen to me, Hogan. If I wanted a comedian, I would have bought one.
I'm not a police captain. Now, you listen to me, and you listen good.
My Lincoln Continental with $1 million. You get this, $1 million of pure stuff inside of it is missing.
It's on one of your streets. It was stolen at the airport, even though my man still has the ignition keys.
How do you know about the stuff?
How the hell would I know? Listen to me, Hogan. I want you to find that Lincoln. It's got license plate number BAK520. You find it. And you drive it personally to my front door.
$1 million.
Partner. How's your case coming along?
Some dumb kid joyriding. It's a wild goose chase.
Let me get this.
All right.
Where's their engines?
Here I am again.
Get on that other phone. You repeat that?
Get a message to your friend Novick. If he wants to be a rich hero,
There's a Lincoln Continental parked in an alley between 4th and Madison.
Hey, just who is this anyway? Are you the one that keeps calling up here? Are you the roadrunner?
Yeah.
Pete, that's the same damn voice.
Yeah, but there's something familiar about it. I think somebody just put this on. Hell, I guess I better check it out anyway. You want to come with me?
Yeah.
I trouble this damn business with one wild goose chase after another.
Keith, you watch the store?
Yeah, sure. Billy, I can't put my finger on it, but there's something wacky about all this.
You don't think there's a gal mixed up in this, do you?
Oh, come on. It'd be like riding a camel backwards.
I'll tell you why. The last time I talked to the boys, Scotty mentioned that there was a gal at the track about a month ago who turned a couple of laps in Romero's Porsche that had a couple of jaws open pretty wide. No, wait a minute. They're into everything now, you know.
Yeah, you're reaching, though.
Look over there. Look. See?
What do we got here?
Maybe we ought to case it for a minute, don't you think?
Yeah, it's good thinking, partner. Here we got a flashlight out of there. Look, I'll check it out. Everything's all right. You follow me out here.
Right.
You see anybody?
Not yet.
All right. Keep a watch for me.
Will do.
So good. All right. Throw him a hot wire.
Easy.
All right, duck down. I'll meet you back there.
Somebody coming, Pete.
All right, get the hell out of here. Get lost.
Gotcha.
wait a minute, guys. I got nothing you'd want to steal. I'm broke. Give me a break, huh?
Baloney!
When you need one.
Novick!
No more Mr. Nice Guy.
Check the doors. Every nook and corner. We gotta find them.
Well, good evening there, hero. Care to help out a young lady in distress?
You're all beyond it, baby.
You seen a pretty boy come by here?
No.
Frosty, let's get back to the car. You can't be too far.
Friday night, we got a special on in case you boys are down this way.
Ciao. Let's go.
Sweet mama, you've been sleeping on the job too much. My baker says the bread in your area is pretty flat.
This neighborhood, man, it's really gone downhill.
Hey, that my man Voodoo.
Hey, Buona Pete, what's going down? How you doing? What are you doing in my heavenly jungle?
Well, I just had a little trouble, and I need a car.
Sure, Pete. Want to live somewhere?
No, I need a car. Hey, look, you can pick it up in front of my place tomorrow morning.
My car?
Hey, listen.
Wait.
No problem, man. I have a
car. Hey, man, where you going with my car? You can take my woman's bones, but don't be taking my car now.
You're using that caddy. Tell him.
I need to know what the boys in the back room are saying. Come on. Come on.
Hey, where are you going?
I need
your
date, man. Look, I need a policeman.
You did. Oh, my God. Look at him.
Come on, look. I got it. Wait, no, no, no.
Oh,
look,
what?
Look, I need to talk to him.
Okay. Oh.
Come on.
Oh.
Out here.
Where are we going?
Out here.
Wait a minute. Slow down. Slow down.
I'm all right.
Wait.
Here. All right. Oh. You all right?
Hey.
Sit down. Are you all right?
Mm-hmm. Are you?
No, I'm in trouble.
Hmm?
Hey, look, I hate to bother you with this, but I don't know who else to bother. I don't know. You guys just want to talk. I don't know. Let me tell you about my day.
Tell me about your day.
Look, you know, I'm used to chasing kids in white Eldorados. You know, go jumping into the water. I get this weird phone call. Some guy said he had a roadrunner. Tells me to go out and pick up his Lincoln Continental and be a hero. Well, like a fool, I go running out there and do it. He set me up. I get jumped by these two different sets of individuals. Two of them are out there dead, the other two are looking for me.
Oh, Petey.
Yeah, I don't know what the hell's going on around here. I can't find out any information from my people in the streets. Billy's people don't know nothing. Well, Hogan's no help.
How much do you know about Hogan?
The cop.
Hogan's involved in the biggest dope ring in this city.
What?
He's in the pocket of a man named Al Spilano.
Oh, get out of here. How do you know that?
Captain Francis Hogan is my stepfather.
Really?
My real daddy was an inventor. And my mother divorced him and married Hogan, and I moved in with them. Hogan is, ambitious. Very flashy. He got promoted, All of a sudden, he's a big deal in the narcotics squad. And then my mama died, and I left home and wound up in San Francisco. My daddy wrote me all the time. A lot about his work. And then a couple of months ago, his letters changed. He sounded very paranoid. He said that Hogan was responsible for my mother's death, that he was involved in this dope deal, and then he named Al Spilano. I thought it was crazy. And 2 days after I got that last letter, I got the word my daddy had been shot by an unknown gunman in the park.
Oh, Nifty. Why didn't you turn Hogan in?
Well, how could I? There isn't any proof.
Well, Hogan and Spilano. I wonder if that has anything to do with those guys hitting on me tonight.
Probably. The Lincoln is registered to Al Spilano. We got it over the wire this afternoon.
Well, that answers some questions. That brings up some more. I think I'll go home and sleep on it.
Good luck.
Thank you, love.
Hold it. Somebody wants to meet you, tough guy.
Oh, why me, Lord?
Good evening. Oh, I give up. What do you want?
Just drive.
Weekends were made for Michelob. Weekends were made for special times. It's the time to have that smooth and mellow beer. It's Michelob.
When the day is special, shouldn't your beer be just as special?
Weekends were made for Michelob.
All set for school?
Mmm.
Bobby gets great dental checkups.
Wish my Betsy did.
She should use AIM.
That blue gel that tastes good?
Oh, AIM is a lot more than good taste. AIM has fluoride. No toothpaste fights cavities better than AIM.
Really?
AIM is clinically proven to reduce cavities. That taste helps. Bobby may be brushing longer.
You've seen his great checkups.
Well, I'm putting AIM head of the class at our house.
Take AIM against cavities. AIM is accepted by the American Dental Association.
Make this a money-saving fall, starting now at Sears Fall Home Appliance Sale. Super values on many Sears home appliances. Save $20 on this Kenmore dryer, $50 on the Sears Color TV. Save $100 on a gas or electric range, $80 on this Kenmore built-in or portable dishwasher. Save big. Hurry to Sears Fall Home Appliance Sale now.
Kenmore, solid as Sears.
These people have one thing in common.
Super.
There are a few of the people who have bought the new six-cylinder, fuel-injected Toyota Celica Supra.
When you got it, you got it.
Its interior is incredible. Power windows and air conditioning are standard. So is power steering, a tilt wheel, and power disc brakes on all four wheels.
When you got it, you got it.
The new Toyota Supra. Hey, when you got it, you got it.
We now return to Speed Trap, starring Joe Don Baker.
Inside.
Mr. Novick. You see, in my car before you wrecked it was a brown valise. Now, I want that valise back. It's that plain and simple.
Oh, yeah. Well, when I went all the way through that car before I hotwired it, I didn't see any brown valise. And I don't have it. I mean, I don't even know what the hell you're talking about.
You really don't?
No.
What a pity. We have certain ways to make it talk, you know?
Hot shot! No! No! You're a cruel man, Mr. Novick. But you're not a stupid one, I trust. Right now, listen here, Mr. Splano. So maybe we can do some business after all. No, I don't do business with pushers. Them ones that live in fancy houses. Oh, yeah. All you gotta do is you find the roadman. You deliver him to me before you take him to Hogan, right?
Yeah, finding him's easy. Catching him's tough. But if I get him, he's yours.
All right. Larry, you escort Mr. Novick to his car. And be nice. What an animal.
Hey, look here, I don't want to hear nothing.
Hi, Pete, it's me. Listen, Billy wanted me to call and tell you that we parked your car at the rear of your apartment.
Well, that's wonderful. I couldn't have waited.
Well, listen, what I really wanted to tell you was I got super relaxed last night, and I saw the medallion a little clearer. Now, it's got some kind of writing on it. But again, that's about all I could pick up. Does it help a little bit?
The hell knows. Hey, look. Yeah, thanks anyway, huh?
Bye-bye.
Yeah, okay, Billy. I should be there in a few minutes. We can pair the list then, okay? Out.
Attention all units in the vicinity of the fairgrounds. Report of a stolen Datsun 240Z headed west on McDowell Road. Estimated speed 50 miles per hour.
You don't.
this time, buddy. Damn, I didn't know this was here.
Thank you, buddy.
Had a little tough luck, huh?
I had him at the fairgrounds, but then he ducked in this tunnel I didn't know about, and there she is.
That's one of my favorite late-night spots.
Yeah, you know I can believe that. Hey, how soon can you fix my car? And I'm gonna need another set of wheels.
Am I not your partner, huh?
Yeah.
I've got your wheels.
Turn these things into? You betcha.
Thank you.
Thank you. Can I get a hot dog here a second, Larry?
All
Seven to control. I've got two funny looking folks running right through the park. Better send me some backup.
What are you trying to do?
Well, I saw them coming, you see. No gas!
Yes, just about set for the start of the Southwest Gold Cup National Day. Ladies and gentlemen, there's a flag. They're off. Moving out of front, the top runner from Southern California, number two, Bounce and Bob Meter going on the outside. Moving apart through the pack now, it's number 194, Billy Van. Van moves up on the inside. Vayner drifts to the outside. On this flat track national, now Van moves up on the inside. Bob moves to the outside, and he wants him, and Bob almost goes down. It is Billy Van out in front. A beautiful Sunday afternoon here. The dust starting to come up. Wait a minute. Wait a minute. There's a car on the track. There's a car is on the track. There's a blue Mercedes-Benz on the track. What is the car doing on the track? We've got a motorcycle wave. Like, I don't know if this is somebody's idea of a joke or what, but we've got a Mercedes-Benz moving up to the pass. Wait a minute. Let's get the flag down. Let's get the flag down. Yeah. The rider's down. I don't know what's going on, ladies and gentlemen. There's a blue Mercedes-Benz on the track. And look, back at the picnic, a Corvette and one, two police cars, two state police cars. Get the riders off the track. There are four. The sack bar, the Corvette right on its tail. Goes up the jump to the outside of the track. I don't believe cars can do this.
Surprises, nothing but surprises.
We've got a knockdown, drag out battle between a Mercedes-Benz and a Corvette. And the crowd is getting enraged. What's going on? The squad car from the infield to try to block it. The Mercedes goes up the jump. It's got him out. Will the Corvette follow him? Yes. And the Corvette almost goes right on its nose.
Holy hell. Who is that guy?
The Mercedes heads across the infield, and here comes the Vet. The Vet is right on the Mercedes' tail. You're seeing a once-in-a-lifetime race, and here comes the clock. And the Mercedes is getting away. Ladies and gentlemen, I don't believe it. The Mercedes is getting away.
Attention all units in the vicinity of 3rd and Willow Street. Suspect vehicle headed south on 3rd Street. Attempt to set up roadblock at 3rd and Willow Street. Repeat. Attempt to set up roadblock at 3rd and Willow Street.
Champion gymnast Kathy Rigby for Stay Free Maxi Pads.
You know, you've never heard a celebrity talk about feminine protection on TV before. Well, I wanted to be the first because I think it's perfectly natural, especially when it's Stay Free Maxi Pads. I can really count on their comfort because they're beltless. They stay in place with a wide adhesive strip, and they're comfortable full-size protection, too. They're the comfort I can count on.
Stay Free Maxi Pads, the comfort you can count on.
I did it!
Hey, number one, at your best on your way.
I finally sold that big white house on the corner.
You're a woman, you need iron each day.
After showing it 31 times.
Take your one a day, today and every day.
Nowadays, a woman keeps going all day. One a day plus iron gives you 100% full potency of iron in one little yellow tablet.
I did it!
Hey, number one!
Chimere, an extraordinary new fragrance. To the world, it's discreet, but up close, it's something else. To the world, it's elegant, But up close, it's something else. Chimere, a new kind of fragrance that captures both sides of a woman. To the world, it's discreet and elegant. But it's something else up close. Chimere.
Mr. White, this isn't Efferdent. It's much bluer.
Jane, it's bluer to tell you it's new, improved Efferdent. The most powerful Efferdent yet.
Most powerful yet?
New Efferdent has 32% more power cleaners. Look, this denture material is badly stained with coffee, but new Efferdent has 32% more power cleaners.
It's clean, even in between.
How'd you like new Efferdent?
Like it. I love it.
New, improved Efferdent. 32% more power cleaners for cleaner dentures.
We will return to Joe Don Baker in Speed Trap. Thursday, The Eyes, revelations about your most magical sense, sight. Next on the incredible award-winning series, The Body Human, a journey into frontiers so extraordinary, a blind man sees his son for the very first time. Thursday at 8, 7 Central and Mountain. The Body Human, the magic sense. Saturday, McQueen and McGraw in The Getaway, a movie special, Saturday at 8:30, 7:30 Central and Mountain. Due to mature theme, viewer discretion advised. This is CBS.
My photos, they are taken now. I want to get some prints, but I haven't got forever, and I'm looking for some hints.
Fox Photo makes a promise that's a written guarantee. You get your prints tomorrow,
or they give them to you free.
Tomorrow, tomorrow. Your pictures tomorrow or they're free. Fox Photo.
One half off developing and printing with coupon from Monday's Times Herald or Tuesday's News.
Firefighters at DFW Regional Airport battled 9 fires today, fires that consumed hundreds of gallons of jet fuel. Now, that may seem wasteful in the wake of our nation's energy crisis, but there was a good reason for it. A practice fire to see how fast crews could move in the case of a real emergency. Join us for the full story tonight at 10 o'clock.
If men knew the real me, they'd love me for my mind and not for my body.
Why you say that?
Joel Gray, Cass Elliott, and Carol Burnett tonight.
We now return to Speed Trap, starring Joe Don Baker.
Jim. Saw him run across that roof. He's inside this empty building.
Come here.
Let's split up. Somebody take the stairway. Ross, come on, come on.
Nasty story. I just didn't finish telling you. Oh.
You realize what this means?
Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. Wait a minute, I gotta get something.
You better not come out of there with a pistol.
Happy birthday.
Well, I suppose you're the genius who invented this magic box, huh?
Oh, my daddy.
Oh.
Daddy was a genius. He sold most of his big important ideas to the automotive companies. This here was just a little toy. But somehow I... Maybe Mama told him. I don't know. Hogan found out about it and tried to force my daddy to sell it to Spillano.
Oh, an automatic car opener. It's a hell of a gadget to fall in the wrong hands. Car thefts at will.
I think they tried to beat it out of him and then kill him for it. But what Hogan didn't know was that my daddy told me where to find it and how to use it.
Which brings us to the big question, Nifty. What'd you do with all them cars you stole? Did you take them to Mexico and sell them? Huh?
No, they're here.
Tell me.
Right here in town, safe and sound. I'll show you.
All right. What about Spillano's heroin?
It's the same place. I'm gonna flush that damn mess. Don't you stop me.
All right. That's what you want. It'll be all right.
Pete, the whole world has been looking for you, Hogan especially. Now, where you been?
Well, I've been busy.
Busy?
Busy.
You! Well, you're the one. The medallion.
New Blossom, you got a real talent. Meet Officer Nolan, one of the city's finest. Nifty, this is New Blossom. Hey, Billy, I hate to hit and run, but can you tell the cops I brought that car back?
Get out of there, you.
Okay. Thanks, old buddy. See y'all later.
I went into Wendy's for the first time. I had a hot and juicy, and I loved it. That night, I had a wonderful dream. I took hot and juicies everywhere. All I could think about was that juicy meat, those juicy toppings. So, I decided to devote myself to bringing pleasure to people just as I have found it. You want a real good hamburger?
Zenith ever. System 3 is even better.
Even better.
The sharpest Zenith picture ever.
Sharpest picture.
An all-modular chassis designed to be the most reliable Zenith ever.
Most reliable.
And now, better sound. Four speakers, audio jacks, even an audio control center.
Better sound.
Zenith. System 3.
System 3.
Now, even better.
Nothing can get rid of these odors like carpet fresh. Rover, who's all over. The old fogey stogie. The damn musties. Once these odors are in your rug, they're in your room. So you need Airwick Carpet Fresh. Sprinkle Carpet Fresh powder on, wait a few minutes, vacuum. Carpet Fresh overcomes the source of odors like nothing else. Your room has a fresh, clean smell. Carpet Fresh, the one and only.
Isn't it a beauty? A Datsun 280ZX.
And it's all mine.
Ours. Am I glad we priced a Z before we settled for something else?
Price a Datsun 280ZX. Don't let that styling, that luxury, that performance mislead you. You could get an EPA-estimated city range of 400 miles and highway range of over 600 on one tank of gas. Price a Datsun 280ZX.
It costs less than you think.
And gives us more.
And now, the conclusion of Speed Trap.
which way?
It's a warehouse. 1245 12th Street. Who was that?
Who?
That girl.
What girl?
That girl with the medallion?
Oh, that girl?
Well, that's a special girl. She's my psychic. I use her in all my cases.
Guess who owns the warehouse?
Howard Hughes.
Francis Hogan.
You're kidding me. Little devil. He stacks all them cars right on his nose. Love it. Hey, tell me something. Where'd you learn to drive like that?
Didn't I ever tell you about that guy I used to go with?
What guy?
Oh, he was something.
Who?
He used to drive the pro circuits. He taught me a lot. Don't you think?
Yeah, yeah.
It's on the right.
What is?
The warehouse.
Oh, yeah.
End of the block on the right.
Awful dark in here.
Oh, wow.
See anything you like?
Oh, yeah, I like that one. And I like that one. Can I have that one over yonder?
Mm-hmm.
Hey, where you got the heroin stashed?
The Rolls Royce.
Of course.
Silly.
Sorry. You expect me coming? Get over there. I know you're in here, Novick.
Well, yes, son. One of those cars right here in my own building.
Hey, Novick. You did pretty good work. I need a couple more things, like the Road Runner and that little brown bag of sugar.
Yeah, well, Captain Hogan, I caught the Road Runner. Any stolen cars, they're a big fat bonus for me. That junk, that's another matter. Oh? Well, maybe we could talk about it.
You all right?
I'm all right. How about you?
Oh, I'm fine. Is there a phone in here?
I don't know. I never saw one.
I didn't think so. Well, we're going to have a classy one-car parade downtown. I never drove Rolls before.
Oh, it's fun.
Want to help me get this back door? Get around there, girl. We're going to lift him in.
All units. All units. Report of shooting at 1245 12th Plate.
Josh reported it coming from inside warehouse.
That sounds like Hogan's warehouse. I bet he's found his stuff. Let's get over that fast.
Is this a big bad wolf sugar?
Uh-huh.
Here you go, Captain. Evidence.
Flush the rest of the stuff if you want to. My plumber says it works better than Drano. Got the keys this thing?
The magic box is in your car. We can't start without it.
All right, I'll open the big door.
Stuck his head out of the car.
I want that police!
Why don't you come here and get it, hotshot?
Go on, go get him.
We don't know where he is in there.
Hey, don't worry, I'll cover you.
Filano's over there.
His name's Loomis. Your captain's in there dead, Hogan.
You believe they didn't mention my name once? On the whole write-up. Well, thank you, Johnny.
You're welcome, Pete.
Appreciate it.
Boy, I spent 18 hours talking trash at those cops. Finally believe my story. Hey, girl, you're in the clear. Can't nobody connect you with a roadrunner or anything, except me.
You gonna turn me in?
Oh, Nifty. Nifty, how'd you like to go to Rio, Amsterdam, Abu Dhabi?
Abu Dhabi?
Abu Dhabi. On a paid vacation. Just me and you and the magic box.
By Peter Novick. That's blackmail.
Oh, I know.
You can't make magic without me.
Yeah, I know. Hey, that radio frequency jammer thing you got, you never did tell me about that.
I'll tell you later.
the CBS Wednesday Night Movies, John Wayne faces an airborne disaster in The High and the Mighty. One man keeps his head while 22 lives hang in the balance. When the pilot panics, John Wayne, as the co-pilot, takes charge. Robert Stack and Claire Trevor co-star in the greatest aviation movie of all time, The High and the Mighty. Wednesday night at 8, 7 Central and Mountain.
Next week, CBS presents the story of one of television's most beloved stars. Can you hear the laughter? The story of Freddie Prinze. He came from the streets with enough talent to take him to the stars.